We're joined with top teacher Jeff Ritter from the Make the Turn Academy at the Pronghorn Resorts in Bend, Oregon. Jeff, you know, when I go to the range, I usually don't work on my greenside chipping, and that's one of my downfalls in my game. You do the fat shots, those thin shots, and the occasional great shot. Want to see if you have a tip for me to be more consistent in the greenside chips.
Yeah, absolutely. Great question. You know, anytime a golfer is struggling with chipping and pitching, it's usually for one or two reasons. Number one, the club's hitting the ground somewhere where the golf ball is not. And number two, the club is interacting with the grass in a way where it tends to get stuck. So the first tip right here is just trying to get good, clean ball then turf contact. The way we're going to do that is by understanding that the location of our nose or the buttons of our shirt in our setup position, that's really setting up where the bottom of your golf swing is going to be. And a lot of players, they set up, they put their weight forward, but they get their nose and their buttons too far behind the ball. And when you do that, the bottom of the swing is too far back. So the basic tip is to get your weight forward, yes, but do so by leaning your entire body slightly towards the target. So if your nose and your buttons are ahead of the ball, the bottom of your swing is going to be ahead of the ball as well. So that's tip number one.
That's great. So when I do greenside chipping, you know, I tend to put my ball position really far back in my stance. Is that correct, or do you have a better solution for me?
You know, that's what a lot of players have been told in the past. And when you put the golf ball too far back in your stance, you really get a lot of forward shaft lean, if you can see that right there. Yep. When you do that, now you've got this leading edge, which is a digging edge. It's going to pitch too much into the grass, and that's when that golf club can get stuck. So a better way to think about this is as you're kind of leaning your body just fractionally towards a target, you want the shaft of the club to lean towards a target about to the same degree. So I've got a little bit of forward shaft lean, but not so much where I'm going ahead and getting that leading edge digging. So the interesting thing about ball position is that it's not as important as what most players make it out to be. All we want to do is hit the ball first. And as long as my nose is ahead of the ball or the buttons of my shirt are ahead of the ball, I'm going to make clean contact. So I was actually on YouTube a couple years ago, and I found a video of Ben Hogan chipping. You never see Ben Hogan chipping videos because everyone just cares about his full swing.
Right.
But he actually had the ball off his front foot. But the thing is that his nose or his buttons were ahead of the ball, and he was hitting these nice, clean shots. So that's when I sort of learned as a coach that maybe the ball position isn't so important. Maybe it's just getting the bottom of the swing in the right spot, and then making sure we don't have too much forward lean in the shaft. And if you have those two things working for you, you're going to hit better shots. You're going to eliminate those fat and thin shots along the way.
Jeff Ritter, you're the top teacher. Amazing. So where can people find out more about you, get a lesson with you, talk about Make the Turn at Pronghorn Resorts?
Yeah, our company is called Make the Turn Performance at Pronghorn Academy at the beautiful Pronghorn Resort here in Bend, Oregon, which is in Central Oregon. We've got a full academy concept, a big staff, fitting professionals, other teaching professionals. We do private coaching. We do masterclass schools, which are three-hour golf schools. We have a great player development program and a lot of other great programs that people can enjoy. For more information, just check us out online at mttperformance.com.
Jeff, really appreciate it. You have a great month.
You too, bud. Thanks for having me on.